Alright, alright, welcome back, all of you Syllable Holics. I am Dr. Lyrical Luck, and I will be your syllabologist for today. Now, first off, happy Monday. Thank goodness it's Monday. It's a good way to start off the week. And what better way to do that than with a little bit of motivation? So happy Motivational Monday. Our motivational song for today is Believe by our patient Eminem. So stay tuned for the end of the video as well. We are going to introduce a new method of doing video requests. So I'm excited to show you guys how it's done. Without further ado, let's dive into the diagnosis of Marshall Mathers with Believe. First off, if you see me itching my arms because this bitch-ass mosquito bit me, he double-dipped on one spot right here. I don't know if you guys can see that. Yeah, a little bitch-ass. So yeah. Without further ado, though, let's get into the diagnosis of Eminem. Believe. Let's get it.
And I started from the bottom like a snowman. Ground up like round chalk and still put hands on you. Staying ground up, that's how I spend time. Sucker free, confidence high. Such a breeze when I pin rhymes. I just got that air about me like wind chimes.
Oh my god. Hold up. Hold up. There's like 100 things we have to break down right there. Marshall. Alright, so he started from the bottom like a snowman, right? Because you have to build the base of the snowman, right? First. Like round chuck. It's a type of beef. Like a beef of the shoulder, I think, is the round chuck. Ground up, round chuck. Ground beef, right? And I still put hands on you. That's how it's... Staying wound up is how I spend time. Okay, let's break that down for a second. So we got the snowman and then round chuck and hands on you. So you have to put hands to build a snowman, right? You have to put hands on you on the round chuck because it's ground beef. You put the hands on the snowman, hands on the ground beef. Staying wound up is how I spend time. And there's hands on the clock, right? But also, if you look at it, staying wound up is how I spend time. A wordplay on spend. Crazy. That's not it, though. Sucker free, confidence high. Sucker free, confidence high. So sucker free means like he's off of drugs, sober, right? Or also it can mean like he don't have much of competition. He stays sucker free. Confidence high. So he's high on his confidence. And he's such a breeze when he pens rhymes. He has that air about him, like wind chimes. That whole scheme, that whole first bar, man, we're like 20 seconds into the song, we're already like, let's get it.
Sucker free, confidence high. Such a breeze when I pen rhymes. I just got that air about me, like wind chimes.
Man.
Another day in the life. Used to have to scrape to get by. Now my community's gated and I made it and my neighbors say hi. I'm giving them pounds. I'm upscale now. Guess it means I'm way in the sky.
Oh my god. Okay. You guys ready for this? It may be a little bit of a longer video, and I'm sorry, but we're syllable-holics. We gotta break those syllables down, baby. So he said, had to scrape to get by. His community's gated, and his neighbors say hi now. So he's giving them pounds, right? Like, pound it. I'm upscale now. I'm way in the sky. The whole weight scheme of it. I'm upscale now. Guess that means I'm way in the sky. He's way in this, and he's way up. He's rich, upscale. Oh my god, you guys understand, right? Jeez, it's too good.
I'm upscale now. Guess it means I'm way in the sky.
And he laughs.
But I still remember the days up. Minimum wage for general labor. Welfare recipients is a minor. Look how government assistance is major. Adversity
effect. Hold up. The small one right there. Minimum wage for general labor, right? Welfare recipient since a minor. Look how government assistance has major. The wordplay on major, major, minor, major.
Recipient is a minor. Look how government assistance is major. Adversity effect. First, you don't succeed. Put your temper to more use, cause being broke is a poor excuse. That's it, only you.
Ooh, man. so many bars. All right. He said, adversity. If at first you don't succeed, put your temper to more use, because being broke is a poor excuse. So if you're faced with adversity, faced with hardship, right? He said, don't let it like cripple you. Don't let it bring you down. Use your temper and how it makes you feel towards your success. Like what he did, right? And he said, being broke is a poor excuse. With like today's technology age, right? Everything's on the internet. There's so many different ways to make money that you don't have to like go out to make money, especially during COVID, right? There's thousands of ways to make money online, YouTube being one of them. I'm not making money yet. Soon, hopefully, right? If you guys allow me to. But being broke's a poor excuse. He said, don't have an excuse to be broke no more. And he said, that's for poor people. That's their excuse. It's because they're broke. Being broke's a poor excuse. It's raw. That's raw and real. Jesus.
Because being broke's a poor excuse. That should only give you more fuel. Show 'em why you're you so close. Got it like I almost got it. But close only counts in time bombs and horseshoes. So I unibomb shit. No remorse. Screw it. I'm lit. And that attitude I blew up on quick. That's why they...
Hold up. He said close only counts in time bombs and horseshoes. That's like the old saying, he switched the wording a little bit. It's like close only counts in horseshoes and hand grenades or something like that. But he switched it up for time bombs and horseshoes because of his next bar, right? Close only counts in time bombs and horseshoes. Now, I don't know if you guys played horseshoes. I used to grow up playing horseshoes with my mom, but horseshoes is actually kind of fun, like a drinking game. Kind of menial, right? You throw horseshoes at a stake, try to get it to like go on the stake. Whoever's closest gets the point. Right, you guys understand that? Being broke, close only counts in time bombs and horseshoes. Sorry, I'm just so fired up. This bang is cracking me out as I take another sip. God, he said, screw it, I'm lit. And that attitude I blew up on quick goes into the Unabomber scheme, right?
No remorse, screw it, I'm lit. And that attitude I blew up on quick. That's why they called me firecracker. I grew up on wick, but a short fuse.
Oof. I grew up, that's why they call me firecracker. I grew up on wick, and then it goes wick with a short fuse. Now, they call me firecracker. You know, like the firecracker sparkler? But they also, cracker is another derogatory name or to describe a white person, right? So they call me firecracker, which a dope white boy, right? I grew up on WIC, which is like the government assistance program for like mothers, right? To get food for their children. WIC with a short fuse. I mean, bar heavy right here, man. Crazy. And then WIC is also like another way to describe like DJing, right? From back in the day, he said, I grew up on WIC, and then goes WIC. So he grew up on food stamps and DJing. And now, if you guys know in his other songs, he always used the chicka, right? Wicka. You guys get it.
Remorse, screw it, I'm lit. And that attitude I blew up on quick. That's why they called me firecracker. I grew up on wick, but a short fuse. I got some important news to report to. Anyone who thought I was done, nah, bitch, not white spot. Lights back on, cop, my fate, where's yours? You still believe in me?
Hold up. Man, shout out to Randy CHRIZ for making this dope-ass video effects, lyric video for Eminem, man. Shout out to Randy CHRIZ and the Meraki United team. It's pretty sweet. Everyone go check him out. I'll put his link in the description below.
Did I get everything I had to give you to make you see? I'll never forget if you turn your back on me now and walk out. I will never let you live it down. I'll never do it. Believe
that build up, man.
In me.
Man, I know sometimes these thoughts can be harsh and cold as ice. To me, they're just ink blots. I just fling them like slingshots and so precise. So you might want to think it over twice. Yeah. Or your retards can roll the dice. But beef will at least cost you your career. Because even my cheap shots are overpriced.
Ooh, that cadence was dope. He said, but beef will at least cost you your career because even my cheap shots are overpriced. Back to the beef scheme, right? He's like, if you're going to be beefing with me, my cheap shots will end your career. They're overpriced. But just like in like a supermarket, right? You get beef at one market, it's one price. The same beef at another market is another price, it's overpriced. Man. But the middle finger is it's free as a bird. Hell yeah. Smash that like button if you guys are still watching this with us.
Ice, well, you retards can roll the dice, but beef will at least cost you your career, because even my cheap shots are overpriced. But this middle finger's free as a bird. No warhead at birth. Hugest forehead on earth.
Hey, me and you. Short with a bird. Me and Marshall both. Hugest forehead on earth, baby.
Studied his formula, learn how to incorporate a curse pointed towards corporate America. Stick a fork in and turn, cause four letter words are more better. Heard the world force better turn to me. You're getting yours.
Oh my god, hold up. Stick a fork in and turn. Obviously it's gonna hurt like shit, right? He's like, I'm talking to corporate America and I'm sticking up the F-U-C-K four letter word, but forks also have like four prongs on it, right? And he said, stick a fork in and turn, because they're more better heard. But the world force fed a turd to me, you're getting yours. So he's like, if you're eating shit, you better get up and keep going.
Heard the world force fed a turd to me, you're getting yours. But sometimes I overdo it. But I just get so into it. I was there consoling you and no one knew it. When right. Your situation showed no improvement, I was that door, you walked over to it. I'm the light at the end of the tunnel, so people are always looking to me as they're going through it.
Ooh, dude, the way he could switch up the flow like that. But if you guys caught what he said right there, right? I don't know about you guys, but I know I listen to music and it's helped me throughout my life get through certain obstacles, right? He's like, I was there consoling you when no one knew it. When your situation showed no improvement, right? When you're going through hard times, he's like, you turn to my CD and me to get through them. He's like, I'm the light at the end of the tunnel. It's true, man. Everyone has those kind of artists and music that they go to get them through hard times.
Over to it. I'm the light at the end of the tunnel, so people are always looking to me as they're going through it. When that tunnel vision is unclear, shit becomes too much to bear. Since cleaning out my closet when I was having trouble with the snare.
Ooh.
I'm that unrealistic prayer answered, and I'ma get you jacked up like you're trying to fix a flat when you struggle with despair.
Hold up. Oh my god. You guys saw that? He led us up to it in the effects. That's a jack right there. One that comes with the car under the word up. I know you guys can't see my mouse, but the whole scheme right there. He's like, I'ma get you jacked up like you're trying to fix a flat when you struggle with despair. So he's gonna motivate you when you're going through hard times. He's gonna motivate you to get up. He's gonna get you jacked up. But that whole scheme of fixing a tire, despair, the wordplay on the spare, like the spare tire, and despair. Jeez, man, smash that like button for all these.
Fix a flat when you struggle with despair. That double-fisted bare knuckles coupled with despair. Nuts I'm cupping, I am your fucking switch. Nothing can compare. Do you still believe?
Man.
In me. Didn't I give everything I had to give you to make you see? I'll never forget if you turn your back on me now and walk out. I will never let you live it down. I'll
you
never
still
quit.
Believe?
In me.
Now, I'm taking this song as like M's talking to himself, obviously the people he's helping, but like when I listen to this song right now, I'm putting myself in his shoes and like taking the lyrics in for myself. Like, do I still believe in what I'm doing? Do I still believe in me? Right? But he's also saying like for his fans, like, do you still believe in me? How do you guys interpret it?
From the bottom like a snowman. Oh man, put that in your corn cob pipe and smoke that.
Man, there's that damn snowman reference again. Like Frosty the Snowman, I'm pretty sure had the corn cob pipe, right? He's like, I started from the bottom, so put that in your corn cob pipe and smoke it, right? A lot of people, they have a good start in life that are maybe already famous, right? Not everyone starts at the bottom and gets to the top like what Eminem did, right? So he's like, I started from the bottom. What can you say about yourself? And I guess Drake did too, right? Started from the bottom, now we're here. Maybe I'll do that one too.
Snowman, oh man, put that in your corn cob pipe and smoke that. But my battery's low, I'm gonna need a boost to my pack. And I know that I always got proof at my back. I called you proof because I knew for a fact.
That line right there I took with, he's like, when you're feeling like you're out of hope, out of energy, or out of like motivation, and you need that boost in your pack, he looks to proof for that, right? So you guys have to kind of find that same thing that helps you get through and stay motivated. If it's a song, if it's like a friend, or if it's a mentor or whatever, you just gotta find it and stick to it. Whatever helps you, man. Everyone's different. So whatever helps you out, you stick to it and keep going, man. I love y'all. You gotta get through this. We'll get through it together.
Need a boost in my pack, and I know that I always got proof at my back. I called you proof because I knew for a fact.
Ooh.
My ace in the hole, homie, I'm calling on you because I think I'm slowly starting to lose faith in its own. Give me that infinite motivation to go. Who's staying with the flow? Fake fans that you're two-faced to this show. Let heartbeats loop, produce hate.
He said, who's staying with the flow? Like a terrorist with the flow, right? That's true, man. He has so many flows, it's crazy.
Motivation to go, who's staying with the flow? Fake fans that you're two-faced to this show. Let heartbeats loop, produce hate in my soul. Laying vocals 2 days in a row. True statement, hate to go down this road. But there's only one route to cross this bridge. So I walk in this bitch with loose chains. Cause all my dues paid, but this boost taking his toll.
Damn, he's like, I've paid my dues, but I'm walking this booth with loose change. But this booth's taking a toll, man. You think of it in two ways, right? Like the booth is taking a toll, like on him, on his personal life. But the booth is also taking a toll. Like he's just going in there and firing off like Hussein, right? Brrr, with all his rhymes. So the booth is also getting worked. Damn.
Cause all my dues pay, but this boost taking his toll. But it's never too late to start a new beginning.
Yeah.
That goes for you too. So what the fuck you gonna do? Use the tools you're given. But you gonna use the card you dealt as an excuse for you to not do shit with him. I used to play the loser victim till I saw the way poop was driven.
Hold up, man. That whole line, that whole bar right there. Hold up. He said it's never late to start a new beginning, right? And that's true. No matter where you're at in your life, you could be 50, 20, you think you failed, whatever. It's never too late to start a new beginning. You hate your job, quit it, find a new one. You don't like your hobby you're doing, quit it, find a new one. It's never late to start. You don't like your relationship, break up, find a new one. Or stay single, obviously, right? Work on yourself. It's never late to start a new beginning. You just have to like stay focused right there, right? He said, I used to play the loser victim as well. Until I saw the way proof was driven. So proof was his motivation. He looked to proof like a mentor and he saw how driven proof was and that inspired him to want to be like that. You just got to find that kind of person for you, man. That kind of information.
This bridge, so I walk in this bitch with loose chains cause all my dues paid but this boost taking his toll. But it's never too late to start a new beginning. That goes for you too. So what the fuck you gonna do? Use the tools you're given. Or you gonna use the card you dealt as an excuse for you to not do shit with them.
Right there.
I used to play them.
Everyone's dealt a hand of cards, man. It depends on how you're playing them. You could let them, you're just like, oh my god, I was dealt this hand of cards. I suck. My life's gonna be shit for the rest of my life. Or you could just be like, I was dealt this shitty hand of cards. So I'm gonna get out of that. I'm gonna find a new hand of cards. Boom. Right? Mindset.
But you gon' use the card you dealt as an excuse for you to not do shit with him. I used to play the loser victim till I saw the way poop was driven. I found my vehicle and I haven't ran out of gas yet. And when they stack decks, turn handicaps into assets. Fanny packs, hourglasses. If time was on my side, I'd still have none to waste.
Okay.
Man, in my younger days, that dream was so much fun to chase. It's like I'd run in place with a shit tangled in front of my face. But how do you keep up the pace and the hunger pangs once you've won the race?
He's like, when he was driven, he's like, I was like, I feel like I was stuck. I was running in place while everything was dangling in front of his face, right? It's like a dog, right? You put a stick to its head and you have like a piece of hot dog, right? That's how he felt. He'll never get it. But he kept going for it.
It's like I'd run in place while the shit dangled in front of my face. But how do you keep up the pace and the hunger pangs once you've won the race? When that dual exhaust is cooling off, cause you don't got nothing left to prove it all, cause you done already hit him with the coup de grace. Still you feel the need to go full tilt. That Bruce Willis, that true still, that true skill. When that wheel's loose, I won't lose will. Do you still believe?
That's powerful. powerful right there. That last little line for Bruce Willis, right? He's like, that Bruce Willis, that blue steel, because Bruce Willis was in the movie Blue Steel. That true skill, when that wheel's loose, I won't lose will. So he's not gonna lose willpower when is feeling like uneasy and uncertain. He's not gonna lose will. The wordplay on lose will, right? Do you still believe? Damn, it's a good ass song, man. Now, does Eminem deserve a refill for the song Believe? Smash that like button for yes. Let me know in the comments which song that you guys use for your motivation personally. I would like to know, and like, so I could check them out too, man. Like, this is one of mine. Phenomenal is another one of mine. That's why I did a video on it. I'd like to know what your Syllableholics, what your guys' motivational songs are that keep you uplifted and up-spirited and positive. Let me know. Leave them in the comments below. Now, does he deserve a refill for Believe? 100%, baby. Motivational Monday? Yes, Marshall, you deserve a refill. Now, you guys agree with that? Let me know in the comments. Smash that like button if you enjoyed this video. And let's move on to the moment we've been waiting for right here. All right. So this is obviously a pill bottle, right? These are not pills. These are all of your guys' requests balled up into a little ball in here. This is how we're going to start doing song requests from here on out. I'm thinking this is my first time, so I'm thinking maybe whatever song gets the most likes, we'll add an extra, however many likes it is how many extra entries we'll put in here for it to be drawn, right? I just want to apologize if I didn't get to your song that you put in the comments. It's just overwhelming. There's at least 52 different requests in here. So, let's shake it up, mix them up. And now, the patient we will be diagnosing next will be, drum roll please, man, Tech 9, Know the Product, Twisted Insane, and Recognize with the song So Dope. Zach, can you see that? Yeah. So Dope will be the next patient and song we do. Let me know what you guys think, and I will see all y'all on the next video. But first, if you enjoy this video, please like and subscribe to this channel. Don't forget to hit that notification bell so you know when I have new videos being released. Follow me on all my social media accounts, and I will see all of you Syllableholics on your bar breakdown follow-up. Peace.